Happy early Halloween, Spuffers. Fast video today. Just wanted to quickly inform anyone who hasn't played a Battlefield game, like myself until recently, that Battlefield 1 is amazing and one of the best multiplayer experiences I've had in recent memory. The animations and textures are gorgeous, sound design is immersive, and there are so many little details that other games ignore. There are first-person legs and shadows and reload animations that use the right number of bullets. They put so much effort into the experience around the gameplay, and it absolutely pays off. Getting into the actual gameplay, which is even more important, the battles themselves feel huge and awesome, 32 players per team, destructible environments that mean the landscape is constantly changing around you, and there are so many ways to tackle that landscape. You can jump and slide and vault fences, peek around corners, or climb through windows, or pick dead people's guns off the ground. Pretty much any time I thought, I wonder if the game lets you do this, it turns out that, yeah, you could. It's a great overall experience, and I'm glad I finally got over my prejudice towards everything EA and gave it a shot. Didn't pay for the game though. Special thanks to my buddy Yes Siri Burb for letting me play on his account. Thank you to Silverwolf for encouraging me to play a Battlefield game, and thank you all for watching. I hope you're all having a great October, and I'll see you in a future video. Just kidding, video's not over yet. I wanted to mention that a few days ago, Battlefield 1 revealed the name and theme of their upcoming DLC expansion, Turning Tides. It's going to focus on naval battles of World War II. The alpha footage we've received so far showcased different classes of boats and a few weapons that saw more action in the seas than on land. My particular favorite is the new grappling hook gadget that will likely be used for boarding enemy boats, but also sounds like it could hopefully be used for mobility strats on any terrain. I haven't played the other DLC for Battlefront 1, nor did they really strike me as particularly attractive, since it didn't feel like they really changed the game in meaningful ways. But Yes Siri Burb and I are probably going to split the cost for Turning Tides, because naval combat is a completely new style of warfare, and one that's a lot less common in the game's industry. I can't really think of any shooter I've played that gave naval combat a starring light, and I've heard that this franchise did a good job with the aquatic maps and Battlefield 4. So I'm probably going to be grabbing that DLC when it comes out in December, and I'll probably give it a separate review at that time. See you then, and hopefully a few videos between then and now. This is Abacus with a Spuff of Legends signing off. For real this time.